Good morning. So it's off to the gym, and I never went to sleep. I think we're gonna instill a sleep challenge, because right now I'm an insomniac. But I made plans to go to the gym, and it's 5 a.m. So that's precisely what I'm gonna do. So I say to Mr. Ambassador, we can go at 8 a.m. so I can get some sleep. But what did he say? He said no. He said let's go at 5 a.m. So I make it all the way over there. And what is the problem, you might ask? Well, see, LA Fitness has this thing where they don't open until 8 on Saturdays. So be fit it is for some meditation and prayer. Whatever you believe in, I personally use prayer as my meditation. Whatever floats your boat. It's amazing that this is video footage and it looks like a picture, how still one can be. I low-key feel like I might have fell asleep in an upright position because I don't think I slept for 24 hours for that. But it's the power of meditation, y'all. I'm just kidding. It is a little challenging at first. I always had an issue just getting everything out of my mind. But I think prayer is the better form for me. But to sit in silence and let a thought come to your head, let it sit for a minute, let it fester, let it boil up and brew and see where it sits with you, and then act on it and continue. It's nice to have that little bit of quiet time and figure out what it means for you and make peace with it and then go on with the rest of your day. It's like a nice little clarifying and cleansing quiet time. Then on came the not so peace, or the gruesome cycles of shoulders and say a little bit of legs. This was definitely painful in my shoulders, but this was for sure the meat of my meditation, and it took me a cool minute to understand the circuits I was trying to create, but I believe it might have been 8 different workouts. Not really any rest, it was just a full cycle of movement. This here was for sure a new movement for me. I've never tried it. It was more of a test. tester to see what it was like. I saw it in an Instagram fitness footage, and I seen it maybe somewhere else, and it just looked really interesting, and I wanted to try it. I for sure felt it in my core and in my lower back. It seems sort of like a girl push-up, but maybe a mixture of a plank. I'll probably try that again and work on form. And then we've got your standard everyday push-up. Just kidding. Decline push-ups, because, I mean, you gotta challenge yourself. These days I don't know how to talk to you. I don't know how to be there when you need me.
Sir Yuli, how are you doing?
What's up?
I think the death came extra early today. I think I'm on 24 hours of no sleep, but we did a circuit for you. I look so excited, trying to contain it.
See that potato looking thing over there? Big old fat hacky sack. That was my bed. And now I have a futon.
And this is my pretty little futon. Very spacious for a little me. I'm so grateful to have it, and it's finally morning, so good morning. In reality, it is nighttime, so I'm gonna get this power nap sleep on, and I have so much planned for tomorrow, and it's gonna be awesome. So bye, and good night. Good morning, I'm awake from my nap. I finally slept, if you can tell. This is real. This doesn't usually happen unless I fall into like...
Alright guys, my music is loud, and that's just a challenge the way I'm driving. There we go. What's the first thing you do when you get in your car? If you said put on your seatbelt, it's wrong. Vlogger's Life says turn on the camera. Kidding, don't do that. I kind of did do that. It took me a minute to get my seatbelts on. But today, that excitement that I've been telling you about is for one, the dumbbell challenge, which you will see. And for two, it's the daddy dates. You might have already seen the dumbbell challenge that kind of ran through my head like you filmed the other way around. Anyway, it's daddy date day. I'm gonna go pick up my dad. We're gonna go to the movies. We're gonna have some good dinner, healthy dinner. I'm gonna try to stay within macros and all that good stuff, but I might eat dessert, you'll see. And that's about it. I'm totally rushing. The movie starts at 4:50 and it's at military time. It's already 4:40 and I gotta get him. I will see you there. Man, one thing I hate doing is rushing. I absolutely hate to rush, and that's totally what I'm doing. I just took a red light, and I really should have told my dad, like, hey, let's meet there, but that's more of like awkward dates. You know how when you like don't know if the date's gonna go good, or you're going on a blind date or whatever it is, or you're not fully certain whether you fully like that person? That's when you meet people there. You drive your own car. Me and dad got that relationship. I'm gonna pick him up and be a nice, gentle woman person. What's up? But yes, just thought I'd share. I'd share a date idea. Smarts. Yes, date knowledge. That's totally a better word. Date knowledge. Not that I really have dates, you know, like, but I just figure be smart, drive separately, be safe, meet in public places first. Yeah. Be smart. Coming at you. Coming at you live from the single girl.
They can, you know, I think they call it like a halogram or whatever.
Hologram.
Yeah, and they put them into the movie. But you see what I'm saying? So it's crazy.
This is Dad.
Hello.
We're having talks about conspiracy theories in the World Series recently. The yearbook of 1973 that said they were gonna win. What do you guys think?
All right. Came out to BJ's. I said we'd be good with our meal, which we did, except for this part. This beautiful peanut butter s'mores pizookie. What'd you think of it, Dad?
Very good.
Take that first bite. It's not really the first bite, but... So worth the calories?
Yes, it is.
That's why nobody knows. We park the truck and we take off running. Hurry up, I hear it coming.
Alright guys, I am home from my dad-daughter date. It was very good. We went to TBJ's. You guys saw that really delicious pizookie. Oh my gosh, it was amazing. I was actually thinking about it, so I kind of knew I was going to get it, even though I told you guys I wouldn't. That was amazing, and I had just like chicken and broccoli and potatoes, so I mean, I had a good meal. This is what I wore, but my hair is kind of a mess. I mean, it kind of went up with a mess. Alex buns, you know, they happen a lot. But it was great. Like I said, we went to BJ's. We never made it to the movies. We were going to see Jack Reacher, the new one, and it was already sold out. But we ended up just talking for the rest of the night, which I think was so much better. We talked about what was new that was going on in our lives, because I don't live with him and I never see him. And it's funny when you're little, like in that whole teen age, you're like, don't want to be seen with your parents. But you know, I definitely miss my parents. I miss my dad. It's a great time talking to him for a long time. You should really spend a long time with your parents, like especially in the ages like 20, and you know, like you guys are bridging that gap of that adolescence and then that parenting. Like you guys can really talk about things. We talked about the Bible and just the family and just caught up with each other. So even though we missed the movie, you know, we made our own new plans and it was a good day and everything always happens for the best. And you always just make your own positivity. I am putting up the 5th video tonight. I'm just wrapping it up, doing a couple edits. And I'll see you guys in the morning. Or the next video. Good night, guys.